Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'm going to give you 7 tips for using the Rotate tool in Adobe Illustrator. And you're going to want to stick around to the very end because that 7th tip is one that I think you're going to find extremely useful. Before we get started, I want to invite you to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss any of my future tutorials. Okay, let's make a couple of objects that we can rotate. First, I'm going to get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M, and I'll drag out a rectangle. Then I'm going to get the ellipse tool, keyboard shortcut L, and I'll draw out an ellipse. I'm going to get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and I'm going to select a rectangle first. And for tip number 1, we're going to look at the rotate tool itself. It's located on the left toolbar, looks like this little circular arrow, and the keyboard shortcut is R. When I click on the icon, you're going to notice that with the object that I had selected on the artboard, a rotate ball has appeared in the very center of the object. And now when I just click on this object with my mouse, I can drag up or down, and it's going to rotate in whatever direction I go. And you can see this little text box, which is next to my arrow, and that's given me the exact rotation that I have of the object. And when I have it where I want it, I'm going to release my mouse. Okay, let's undo that rotation, keyboard shortcut Command Z. And for tip number 2, I'm going to show you how to constrain the rotation. And what I mean by that is I'll hold down the Shift key, and when I move either up or down, the rotation is constrained to 45 degree increments. So here we go, 45, 90, 135, and then on around and back to 0. So the tip number 2 is use the Shift key to constrain the rotation. Tip number 3 is that you can move the rotation ball anywhere on the object. So if I want to rotate from this top right anchor, all I have to do with the Rotate tool active is to click on the anchor, and then as I drag around, the rotation occurs right here on this anchor. If I want to rotate from the bottom left anchor, I click here and it's rotating from that bottom anchor. And I don't even have to click on an anchor. I can click anywhere on this object at all, and it's going to rotate around the ball wherever I have clicked. Now let's delete this rectangle. And I'm going to get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and I'm going to move my ellipse here. For tip number 4, I'll show you that when you have the rotate tool active, keyboard shortcut R, you can move the rotation ball outside of the object onto the artboard and rotate it from there. So let's just click here underneath this ellipse, and now you'll see that I am rotating around this rotate ball, and the rotate ball isn't on the object at all. And the other thing that's really neat about this is for tip number 5, when I rotate, I can actually make a copy. So I'm going to hold down the Option key, and as I rotate, you'll see that I'm making a copy. And then the great thing about this is while this copy is selected, I can duplicate that same exact move with that same exact rotation from this rotate ball by using the keyboard shortcut Command D. And each time I do that, I'm creating another petal around a flower. And when I do this last one, you'll see that there's an overlap. And the unfortunate thing about this method is I've got to really do a lot of trial and error so that I can get my petals exactly spaced out on my circle. But I'm going to show you in a minute how to do that with a foolproof method. Let's undo those petals. Keyboard shortcut Command Z, and I'm just going to keep repeating that until I get rid of those. And for tip number 6, I'm simply going to press the return key on my artboard. Now, I already had the rotate tool active, so pressing the enter key opens the rotate dialog box. And from here, I can choose whatever angle I want. So I'll type in 20 degrees and press the return key. And I'm rotating here from the center of the object. Let's undo that, keyboard shortcut, Command Z. And I want to rotate from down here below. So I'll click down here and then I'm going to press the enter key again. And that opens the rotate dialog box. But did you see what happened? The rotate ball moves back up to the center. And so I'm not going to be able to choose the rotation and rotate from where I had moved that rotate ball. Well, let's close this out and cancel it. Let me show you that if you'll hold down the Option key and click, that opens up the rotate dialog box and it leaves the rotate ball where you wanted it off of the object. Now I can type in 20 degrees and I could just press OK, but I'd like a copy here. So I'm going to press copy and now I have a copy here. And again, we can go through and duplicate that, keyboard shortcut Command D, and I'll keep pressing Command D till I get all the way around to the center. And those actually look pretty well spaced. And that's because they're 360 degrees in a circle. And I used a multiple of that by choosing 20 degrees. So I should have 18 petals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So you're getting the idea a little bit about how objects are spaced, and that is by using divisibles of 360 degrees. Now let's undo these, keyboard shortcut Command Z. Now here's tip number 7, which I promised you. You can evenly space a specific number of objects in a circle, and Illustrator will calculate the exact rotation needed. I have the rotation ball where I want it. I'm going to hold down that Option key and click. That's going to open the rotate dialog box. And let's say that I want 12 petals on my flower, and I want it to rotate from right here. Well, remember, there are 360 degrees in the circle. So what I'm going to do is type in 360 divided by. Now, the divided by sign is a forward slash. And then I'm going to type in 12. And with these instructions, when I press copy, Illustrator is going to give me the second of 12 petals that'll be evenly spaced around my circle. And if I duplicate this 10 more times, let's just do that, Command D, and I'm going to come all the way around here. Now I have 12 petals and they are exactly spaced around the circle. That's tip number 7. So when you want a specific number on your rotation to go around a circle, this is how you do it. Let me just give you one more example. I'm going to select these petals and remove them. I'm going to drag out a star and let's change its color to blue. Then I'll make a circle of stars. With my star selected, I'm going to get the rotate tool, keyboard shortcut R, and I'm going to move my cursor down away from the star, and I'm going to hold the Option key down and click on the artboard, and let's make 15 stars in this circle. So we type in 360 divided by 15 and press copy. Those are going to be pretty close. I think I don't want them quite that close. So I'm going to undo that and come back here and hold down the Option key and click again. And let's do 360 divided by 11 and press copy. And that's a little bit better. All right, I'm going to duplicate this. We're looking for 11 stars equally spaced. Command D, and I'm pressing this over and over again until I have my 11 stars. And that is the cool tip number 7. Well, I hope that you found this video useful and that you'll remember these keyboard shortcuts so that your rotations can be done easily and quickly as you're working on your projects. And again, I want to remind you, click that subscribe button so that you don't miss any of my future tutorials. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.